guys, welcome back to Coach's Corner. Today we're talking about run cadence and what you should be shooting for when you're out there on the roads or even the treadmill this winter. So for a long time, people have been shooting for this 180 steps per minute. And the reason is there's this high-esteemed, legendary coach, Jack Daniels, that had observed Olympic athletes. He had assessed what their cadence was, and he found that on average, the elite athletes were hitting that 180 to 200 steps per minute. And that's good and grand, but we aren't all elite athletes and we're not all the Olympic level athlete, or we don't all have that same body type, the same proportions. So we want to make sure that although that is a gold standard to try to achieve, there are some differences based on your stride length, your body size, your muscle distribution. So the strength of your quads versus your hamstrings. And so it's important for us to find a baseline of our own cadence and then try to improve from there, whether it's 5 to 10% increments over the course of 4 to 6 weeks at a time, or maybe over the course of a season, trying to improve about 10% in that cadence regularly. Or maybe it's improving on our aerobic recovery days, that cadence. Maybe we get a little sluggish when we're out there slow, and so too goes our turnover, and that starts to slow down. But find the baseline for you and then start to increment the progression upward. Although 180, like I said, is a good number to shoot for, keep in mind that not everybody, based on their size and those other factors, may be able to achieve that 180. So figure out what's gonna be best for you, number one, first and foremost. The reason that cadence is important is because if we have a slow cadence, that typically means that we have a long stride and we're overstriding. So we're landing out in front of us heel first, which is a braking mechanism. So that means that our force is sending us backward, which is the opposite of what we want to be doing when we're running. We want to be propelling our force forward. And by having that higher cadence and shortening that stride length just ever so slightly so that we land underneath ourselves, so under our center of gravity, we're able to continue our momentum forward and push the force into the ground and send us forward instead of that braking motion backward. Okay. On top of that, when we do have that higher cadence and we're able to land right underneath us, the distribution of force through our body is a little bit better and helps us with injury prevention than when we're overstriding and again, landing on that heel out in front of us, where that force is being sent up through the ankle, through the shin and into the knees, which is something that we don't want to have happen, right? We want that force to be distributed throughout our whole body to have that cushioning effect so that we're able to brace ourselves and avoid those injuries, especially like those stress fractures or those knee injuries that can occur from that overstriding. Okay. It's going to take some practice to get that cadence up. So once you find that baseline, whether you're using your watch that tells you your cadence, or maybe you're heading out for an easy run and you're going to check your watch each minute and count one leg every time it hits the ground to figure out what your baseline is. Now, it's going to be more accurate if you're using something that's counting for you and you're not aware that you're counting, because certainly when we're aware that something's being assessed, we tend to change our pattern. So we tend to run faster or slower, and that may impact our cadence. So if you don't have something that counts for you, maybe have somebody else count your steps for you, or you can hit a track or a set course where you know the distance, you know what your pace is supposed to be, so that you can keep things a little bit more controlled to find that accurate baseline. From there, we can start to work on drills to improve our cadence. So whether it's A skips, B skips, the wall cycles that I've posted on my Instagram page, all of those are things to practice landing underneath you, which is exactly where we want to land when we're out there running. And by performing those drills regularly, we can start to feel those changes start to occur in our natural stride. So I encourage you to include those drills pre-run, maybe even on your off days, to start to feel what that cadence is going to feel like. Another strategy you can use is simply running to music at the cadence you want to achieve and make sure you're landing on the beat. I know many people that have created playlists, and you can even search the cadence of different songs, the metronome readings for each of the songs so that you can find that accurate tune so that you can practice as well. But ultimately, by landing underneath us, having a more efficient stride, we're gonna be faster. So get that baseline and then slowly start to implement those drills and those strategies to improve that cadence over the course of this winter, and you'll see big changes come next spring when races resume. As always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next week here at Coach's Corner.